calculations enable you to create new data and answer questions that cannot be answered by the source columns. Simple and complex calculations can be created in a data module and are available to all Cognos Analytics components, explorations, dashboards, stories, or reports that use that data module. This helps ensure consistency and accuracy by creating a calculation in one place where it can be used by many. In this video, you will see how to create a simple calculation using two numeric values, how to use a calculation to create a target or baseline value, how to use a calculation to manipulate text using functions, and how to create a complex calculation. The call center data module will be used as the starting point for this video. To create a calculation using a single column, I select the numeric column, more, create calculation. The create calculation pane opens up. In this case, I want to create a column that will show a 15% rise in call count. Notice as I change the expression, the name changes above as well. The new column appears at the top of the list, and I can see in the grid that it now has a value of 1.15. I can use a calculation to create a value that I can use as a target or baseline. In this case, I select more at the top of the table that I want to use, click calculation. Expression editor opens this time, and I type the value I want to use as the target. I want to select calculate after aggregation because I don't want the target value aggregated in my visualization as that would result in extra counting. Giving it a name, and click OK. And I can see in the data grid that it appears as 10,000 on every row. A simple calculation can be created using two numeric values in the same table. So for example, to calculate the percentage of call handle time that is spent talking, I can select talk time and handle time, more, and create calculation. In this case, because I want a percentage, I can click the percentage expression. The math will be done for me. And I can see in the data grid that the percentage is calculated for each row that I have data. Calculations can be used to manipulate text. The result of a calculation does not have to be a numeric result. To create a new column, which is the agent's full name, I click More, Calculation, Expression Editor opens. There are a number of functions that are available to me. In my case, I know to build my text field, I want to use the concatenation function. I could look for it in the common function, but I'm going to start to type it. And as soon as I do, type ahead starts to show me all the functions available that begin with CON. I'm going to select concat. I'm going to come up to the query subject tree. I'm going to pull out and drop last name. And I want to have a comma separating the value. So I'm going to put that into my concatenation. Notice that I'm using single quotes here. And because I'm in the expression editor, I can validate my result. Expression's good. And I can also do a preview. So I can see I have last name, comma, first name. That's exactly what I want. And I'm going to give my column a name and click OK. Complex calculations drawing data from multiple tables can also be created. The only requirement is that the tables must be joined. I know in my case, agent has a relationship with the call log. I want to create a cost per call column. In this case, I come up to the data module name to click more. I see the list of tables available to me, so I can go to agent and pick up hourly rate. I'm going to divide it by 3600 because I want to create a per second rate. And I'll put that in parentheses to make sure that math gets done first. And then I'm going to come down to the call log and pick up the total handle time. Again, I can validate that my calculation is correct, and I can preview the results. Now that looks wrong to me. So what's going on? Well, the thing I forgot to do was deselect calculate after aggregation because I don't want the hourly rate aggregating. Let's try that again. That looks much better. I can see the value at the top of my list. Now, there's a couple things that I should do as well. One of the things that I want to do is because of the way I'm planning to use cost per call, I'm going to change it from total to average. So when I display it, for example, in a summary, it will be the average cost per call across all calls. If I had intended to use it to add up the total costs of calls, I probably would keep it as total, but give it a different name. The other thing I can do is changing the format because, again, because it's a currency, it's a monetary value, I can use the format currency and make sure that it always shows two decimal places and the fact that I want it to always appear at the dollar sign. This concludes the video on how to add calculations to your data modules. Once you save them, they're now available to all your report authors.
Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.